Federal prosecutors today filed charges against the lone gunman. The FBI is now going through his computer trying to come up with a motive. Tonight, we spoke with a local man who has worked in Afghanistan and Kosovo, along with working several years for Homeland Security. He tells our Kristen Drew, expect more of the same.
Steve, the domestic terrorism expert I spoke with, says the Arizona shooting is just the tip of the iceberg.
This is just the beginning. Just the beginning. I guarantee you.
Dennis Clark, a domestic terrorism expert, says mass shootings across the U.S. will continue against politicians on all levels, the head of corporations, and school boards.
Please don't. Please.
Like this incident in Florida last month after a man fired shots during a school board meeting.
It's going to keep happening. And the bad thing is you're trying to fight the real terrorists, you know, international, and you know, there's only so many people and so many resources that can go around.
Resources such as money for security details during public events. However, Clark says there are not enough federal officers to give all members of Congress protection.
I mean, they're going to have to just pull back with as much contact as they used to have with the public, because it's the world's just getting crazier and crazier and more dangerous and more dangerous.
Congressman John Yarmuth expressed a similar concern hours after he learned of the shooting involving his friend and colleague, Congresswoman Gabby Giffords.
And when a public official is doing exactly what virtually every American would want her to do, and she is, her life is threatened, then we all ought to be very, very concerned with the state of our nation.
Clark says there are many factors contributing to the anti-politician attitude and sporadic acts of violence, but he says the economy is a strong element in the mix.
If people are already angry about something or upset about something, and then they get hit with the bad economy, it sort of pushes, maybe the straw that breaks the camel's back.
In the case of the Arizona shooting, Clark says there were red flags with posting on the internet made by the alleged shooter, but Clark says there's not enough intelligence to follow each person like that. Live in the newsroom, I'm Kristen Drew, WLKY News.